All right, ladies and gentlemen, you have in front of the DJ app from Algorithm. I'll put a link in the description to take you to the Algorithm site and also to check to see if the Android phone or the PC you've got is compatible with this software. And hi, Yvette. And Blaze, hello, have you got some dab dabs there? Are you in the mix? It's that dab dabs. He just loves playing with buttons and knobs. Right, okay. So there it is, that's the DJ app, and I'm running this on my Mac at the moment. So top left-hand corner, we have the Apple icon. Next to that, we have the DJ icon. I'm going to click on there, and I'm going to go to Preferences and click there. In the center now of the screen, I've got General. So we'll run through some of the features that I feel you should set if you are, let's say, for example, a mixing DJ. Automatically jump to start point, you want that. Reset EQ effect controls, you want that. You don't want it to automatically start when playing a song, because what that will do, as soon as you drag a song to one of the virtual turntables, it'll automatically start. Really, as a DJ, you want to get it set, ready, and you want to be the person starting the track, not the program. Start delay time and stop delay, I've set that to zero. Speed range, we can go anything from 8, 10, 25, 50 or 75. Ideally, if you're a mixing DJ, you want to stick around the 8 or 10, I've set it to 10. Invert slider. Now what that will do is, at the moment, without that highlighted, it means if I bring the slider down, it will speed up, and up, it will slow down. By inverting it, it means if I take it up, it will speed up, and down, it will slow down. Now, ideally, if you imagine, if that was sort of set flat, what's he doing?
He's having a poo.
Oh, bless him.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear. Okay, this is family life for you. Poor lad. I don't know whether to put this on, actually. Ah, what the heck. All right. So I would ideally not highlight the invert slider. Crossfade curve, you've got three ways of setting it. Default, linear or cut. Default and linear if you're a mixing DJ. Cut if you're a scratch turntablist. I've set it to default. And distinguish minor and major keys. I've highlighted that. Major and minor keys, right. Major keys, the way of defining them, or an easy way of explaining them, they make you feel good. They're very high, they're very uplifting. Minor keys are very low, very deep, etc. So if you do play a set in minor keys, then, and you want to uplift the crowd, you want to get them a little bit hyped up, then chuck a major key in and just notice the difference, all right? So that's a general look at general. We'll go to devices. Now this is when you will maybe need to look at this if you're going to plug in an external controller with a built-in sound card. If you do that and you have the correct software plugged, you have the correct software downloaded, or the correct software that you've put into your controller, your laptop, then once, sorry, not into your controller, if you have the correct software that you've had on, say, a CD, or you've downloaded and you load that into your PC, then theoretically the controller should be able to talk to the program. But of course you need to make sure that the controller you're using is compatible with the DJ app. That's very important. Now at the moment I haven't got anything plugged in here, but if I was to plug in a controller that can be used with the DJ app, then you would see other icons appearing. So at the moment, if I just click on the built-in output, there's nothing else that's happening. It's just got built-in output. And pre-queuing, that's it. I can split output or none. So I'm just going to leave it to none for the moment. Auto mix. What this will do, this will automatically mix the tracks for you. And I would say, as a DJ, if you're going to take this out on the road, you don't want to do that. Unless, of course, you are, let's say, going off for a drink or a pee, or you just want to leave this for 20 minutes, then by all means use auto mix. Appearance, there, the next one, is down to the appearance of the skin. And advanced, a little bit more advanced here, but we can look at auto gain, automatically adjust song playback volume to the same level, remote control, look for iPhone, iPod, touch remotes. The DJ Remote app lets you control DJ via Wi-Fi. So again, if you are in a Wi-Fi area and you have compatible Androids that are Wi-Fi suited, then you can play tracks from them as well. But of course, you've got to make sure everything you've got is compatible. I would say that's about it for the very basics of looking at the preferences. And again, just to confirm, we go to the DJ on the left, top left-hand corner of the screen and go down to preferences. Also there, we we have Register DJ. You can provide feedback, learn about DJ accessories, DJ for iPhone, iPad, services. So everything is there. If you are on the web while you're having a mix and you have problems, then you can, with a few clicks, go directly to the information that you'll need. So I hope that's been a help. This is a very, very simple DJ app to use, but it's very clever. It's very simple, and it's a fantastic way of mixing. Even if you're not a DJ, you could have something like this and just mess around with your tunes with your mates at home. All right, so check out the link in the description, and I will say practice and enjoy. Thank you.